Hi everyone, welcome to Electrochemistry NEET Series 2020. In this video we are going to discuss about previous NEET questions one by one. First let us start with first question. In electrochemical cell, zinc sulfate of concentration 0.01 molar separated with copper sulfate of 1 molar concentration dipped in copper, if its EMF is E1, when the concentration of zinc sulfate changed to 1 molar and the copper sulfate changed to 0.01 molar, the EMF is E2. Find the relation between E1 and E2 if RT by F is equals to 0.059. It's a 2017 question. First, write the formula. E1 is equals to E0 cell minus 0.059 upon number of electrons log concentration of zinc plus 2 upon concentration of copper plus 2. Here in the beginning zinc is 0.059 by 2 electrons transferred, log zinc concentration given as 0.01 upon 1. Now 0.01, how can we write, students? Minus 0.059 upon 2 log 10 power minus 2. This is in the form of log a power x, students. Then I can write this as minus 0.059 by 2 minus 2 into log 10. Students, I have written it as in the form of x log a form. Now 2 cancel, log 10 is 1. So it is E0 cell, E1 is equals to E0 cell minus 0.059, students. Now let us find E2. Again take the concentration E0 cell, that is equals to E0 cell minus 0.059 upon 2 log concentration of zinc given as 1, students, and copper now changed to 0.01. So this is 10 power minus 2. If it goes up, it will become 10 power plus 2. Then you can write this one as E0 cell minus 0.059 by 2 log 10 power 2, students. So it can be written as 2 log 10. E0 cell minus 0.059 by 2 into 2 log 10, students. Log 10 is 1 again. 2 cancel. But here minus 0.059, here plus 0.059, because here minus minus becomes plus, here minus is retained as it is. So E1 is E0 cell plus 0.059, E2 is E0 cell minus 0.059, then E1 is greater than E2, students. E1 is greater than E2. Now, second question. Molar conductivity of a 0.5 mole centimeter cube solution of silver nitrate with a conductivity of 5.76 into 10 power minus 3 Siemens centimeter inverse at 298 Kelvin we have to conduct. So we have to find out molar conductivity of a 0.5 mole per centimeter cube solution, student. Then it is given in 2016 paper. Now formula for this, lambda m, molar conductance, lambda m is equals to specific conductance k into 1000 by molarity. K given as 5.76 into 10 power minus 3 into 1000 means 10 power plus 3 upon 0.5 mole centimeter minus 3. Now this cancel, 5.76 upon 0.5, I can write it as 1 by 2. So 1 by 2, 2 goes up, it will become 5.76 into 2. Then it is 11.52. Why? Because 76 2s are 152. So 5 2s are 10. So 11.52. This is molar conductance. Answer is option B. Now let us try to solve question number 3. During electrolysis of molten NaCl, time required to produce 0.1 mole of chlorine using 3 ampere current. This is 2016 question again. So we have to find how much time required. So for that, we should know a formula, Faraday's law, that is W is equals to Z into I into T. Z is electrochemical equivalent, that is E by 96,500. This is chemical equivalent, this is electrochemical equivalent. So chemical equivalent divided by 96,500, you will get electrochemical equivalent. Into I, current, how much current is used? 3 ampere current. Into time is T. Weight, if you want weight, moles you should multiply with its molecular weight, 0.1 mole. Chlorine molecular weight, Cl2 is 71. Now 0.1 into 71, you can take it as 7.1. ultimately we want time here. Then T is equals to 0.1 into 71 into 96,500 divided by 3 into E, equivalent weight of Cl2. Now what is the equivalent weight of chlorine, student? It is 35.5. Let us see that. T is equals to 0.1 into 71 into 96,500 upon 3 into 35.5. Then 1 time, 2 times. Now 0.1, if you multiply with this, we'll get 96,500 will become 9,650. Into 2 upon 3. Now this is in seconds. If you want to get minutes, you can also multiply with 1 by 60. Then we'll get it in minutes. Directly in the formula, what we get is seconds. If you divide with 60, it will become minute. Now 2's are 30 times. Then it is 9650 upon 3 into 30, 90. Then cancel this. It is 965 upon 9. So almost it is 10 to 11 times. Now let us see the options. We have 55, 110, 220, 330. So it is 100, 900, again 97s are, then 6, 9 into 7, 63, then it is almost 107 times. So the answer is B, which is approximately 110. It is in minutes. Now let us solve next question. So fourth question, if E0 cell is negative, which of the following give correct relation for delta G naught and K equilibrium constant. This is given in 2016 paper and 2011 paper also. For this, we need to know just two formulas in a simple way, students. Delta G naught is equals to minus NF E naught. Second formula, delta G naught is equals to minus NRT LNK. If it is log, 2.303 will be there. If it is, there is no log, only LNK will be there. Right, students? Now, first what they give? If E naught cell is negative, if E naught cell value is negative, delta G naught will be positive. Delta G naught will be positive means delta G naught greater than 0. If this is positive, minus NRT LN K. K value should be less than 1. Less than 1 in the sense 0.1, 0.2 that way. In that case, log value will become power minus. The minus will become cancel with the minus and become plus. That means in case if I take minus NRT LN 0.1. Then it is 10 power minus 1. Minus 1 log minus log 10 power minus 1 is minus log 10. So minus minus will become plus. That means the K value should be less than 1. Delta G naught greater than 0. K value should be less than 1. So answer is this. Delta G naught greater than 0. K value is less than 1. Now let us solve fifth question. The number of electrons delivered at cathode during electrolysis by the current of 1 ampere in 60 seconds. The time is in seconds only. If the charge of electron is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. This is 2016 question. Q is equals to I into T. Because I is equals to Q by T. Now Q is equals to I into T. So, Q is equals to I 1 ampere T 60 seconds. 1 into 60. Then that is equals to 60 coulombs. Now, how many electrons are derived because of this? So, for that, 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs is equal to 1 electron, student. Then 60 coulombs, how many electrons we'll get? Just cross multiply. Then it is x is equals to 60 upon 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. So 16 threes are 48, then remaining is 12. Now this is right answer. So 3.7 into 10 power 20. So we need not to do complete calculation also. In the 3 points only one answer is there, that is 3.7 into 10 power 20. Now let us solve. Sixth question, students. Question number six. The pressure of H2 required to make the potential zero in pure water at 298 Kelvin in a hydrogen electrode. This question is from 2016. So let us solve this question, students. For that, first thing what we should know is pH of pure water is 10 power minus, sorry, 7. And the concentration of H plus in pure water is 10 power minus 7. So this you remember. Now if you take H2 and oxidize, it will form 2H plus plus 2 electron. Now from this equation, if you apply Nernst equation, E is equals to E naught minus 0.059 upon 2 electrons 2 log h plus, how many 2 are there? Then you should write h plus whole square upon pressure of H2. Pressure of H2. Then it is equals to E naught minus 0.059 by 2 log h plus concentration, how much student? 10 power minus 7. Now this 10 power minus 7 2 times square, 10 power minus 7 whole square upon pressure of H2. So we should calculate pressure of H2 only. Then this is 0 because hydrogen electrode E naught is 0, minus 0.059 by 2, then it is log 10 power minus 14 by pressure of H2. When this whole value becomes 0, the total potential will become 0. That means the log value should become 1. So log of 10 power minus 14 upon pressure of hydrogen should be equal to 0. Then 10 power minus 14 by pressure of H2 should be equal to 1. Then pressure of H2 should be equal to 10 power minus 14 atm. So simple. So what we did here, this entire value should become 0. For that, log of this value should be 0. Log of what is 0? Log 1 is 0. Then the ratio of these two should be equal to 1. Then pressure is equals to 10 power minus 14 atm. Hope it is clear, students. Now let us solve this question, students. The weight of silver, atomic weight is 108, displaced by quantity of electricity that displaces 5600 ml of O2 at STP. So we have used some current. With that help, we displace 5600 ml of O2. With the same current, how much silver is deposited? That we have to find it. For that, formula is weight of silver upon equivalent weight of silver is equals to weight of O2 upon equivalent weight of O2. Now let us see how easy, students. Weight of silver we should find, it is X. Equivalent weight of silver is 108, because atomic weight is given 108, its valency 1. So equivalent weight also 108. Then weight of oxygen, how much, student? We don't know, but they gave 5600 ml of O2, student. 22,400 ml is 1 mole, student, that is 32 grams. Then 5600 ml, it is 4 times decreased. Then if this is 32 grams, this will be 8 grams. Because 4 times if the volume decreases, weight also decreases 4 times. Then it is 8 grams. Equivalent weight of oxygen, how much, student? 8 only. Because 16 by valency 2. So equivalent weight also 8. Then X is equals to, this is 1. So it is 108 grams. So silver deposited, how much, students? 108 grams. It is so easy. Only what you have to do is you should remember this formula, students. Next question. At 25 degrees centigrade, molar conductance of 0.1 molar ammonium hydroxide is 9.54 ohm inverse centimeter square mole inverse. And at infinite dilution, its conductance is 238 ohm inverse centimeter square mole inverse. The degree of dissociation is, it is so simple, students. Degree of dissociation in terms of conductance is alpha is equals to lambda m by lambda infinity. What is lambda m molar conductance in the regular case? That is 9.54 ohm inverse centimeter square mole inverse upon lambda at infinite, 238 ohm inverse centimeter square mole inverse cancel each other, then it is 9.54 by 238 student. Then we can write this one, 954 into 10 power minus 2 upon 238. So definitely it will be 4 times, because 200 into 4, 800, 38 into 4, 120, and 8 into 4, 32. So 238 into 4, 32, 4 3s are 12 plus 3, 15, 4 2s are 8, 952. So 952. So it is 4 times, 4 into 10 power minus 2, then it is 0.04. Then this is dissociation. Percentage of dissociation is into 100 students. Then it is 4% dissociated. So it is 4.008% dissociated. And this is answer for this. Now let us solve 11th question, students. Question number 11. A hydrogen electrode in HCl of pH 10 and the hydrogen at 1 atm, hydrogen gas at 1 atm, what is the potential of the electrode would be? So remember, student, first of all, pH 10 is not possible for HCl. So if it is POH, it may be right, but it is given still pH. So it is not exactly correct, but still, as it is given in the question, let us try to solve as it is. Now for that, E is equals to E naught cell minus 0.059 by 2 log H plus concentration, H plus whole square upon pressure of hydrogen. So for that, here E naught cell, anyways it is 0, but concentration of H plus, if the pH is 10, H plus concentration is 10 power minus 10, then it will become minus 0.059 upon 2 log 10 power minus 10 whole square is 10 power minus 20 upon pressure of hydrogen. Pressure of hydrogen 1 atm it is given. Then it is minus 0.059 into 10 power minus 20, log 10 power minus 20 is minus 20 log 10, log 10 is 1, so it is minus 20 by 2, 2 times, 10 times, then you can minus minus will become plus, so plus 0.0, anyways 110 is there, no, 0.59 is a potential, student. Now let us solve 12th question, students. Molar conductivities of few substances at infinite dilution are given, that is NaCl, HCl and sodium acetate, 126.4, 425.9 and 91 respectively. Then lambda naught for acetic acid should be calculated. Let us solve this question by using Kolrosch law. Lambda naught NaCl is equals to 126.4, for HCl 425.9, for acetate, so CH3COONa, sodium acetate, 91. Then lambda CH3COOH is equals to lambda CH3COONa plus lambda HCl minus lambda naught NaCl. So for sodium acetate it is 91, for HCl it is 425.9, take it as 426 if you want, minus lambda naught NaCl 126.4. then you can write it as 425.9, I'll take it as 426. So 426, 91, 7, 2, 9, 11, 517, minus 126.4. Then it is 390. So lambda CH3COH, lambda naught for CH3COH is 390 Siemens centimeter square mole in